All right, what the heck? Hello. Welcome, everybody, to the live stream. Hope you're all doing well. Thank you for tuning in. Yes, so I just want to apologize right off the bat because I had originally scheduled this stream for 11 a.m. Can you hear me this time? I better make sure you can hear me before I just start rambling. I had scheduled the stream for 11 a.m. and Rosie woke up pretty horribly sick, sore throat, coughing and stuff. But she took a COVID test and she was good to go on that, so she went to work. I don't know how she does that. I definitely wouldn't if I was feeling... I guess she started feeling a little better. But I postponed the stream because I thought she'd be staying home and I'd have to take care of her. Anyway, she's a trooper, man. So she is going on with her day. Anyway, welcome. Let's see here. Radio Rafa, what's the haps on the craps? What? Paul, welcome. Hijinx, Purple Dracos, Ollie, Home Gnome, Glenn Kelly, Paul, Esther, Rosie. I hope you're feeling okay. 2A Bug, Ryan, I totally get you about the tagging thing on mobile. Water Walker, welcome. Matt, Cookie Monster, let's see, Purple Dracos, sorry if I'm repeating names, Home Gnome, 2A Bug, welcome everybody. Yeah. So, anyway, I hope you're all doing well. I know there's just seems like there's a lot of stuff going around right now, sicknesses and otherwise. Four Bleats, welcome. Emil, thanks for tuning in. Chase, got this on mute because I don't want to hear the song. I shouldn't, just saying good vibes, saying hi. Also, B says hi to Rosie. Aw, thanks so much, Chase. I guess you can't hear me since it's on mute, but I really appreciate that. Hopefully you'll catch what I'm saying on the replay. If you haven't seen Chase's reaction to Unleash yet, it's very good. He catches so much stuff on his first listen. It's really impressive. All right, let's see. Think Ubi Doob, welcome. I hope I'm not missing anything important. Rosie usually reads what the chat actually says. So if there's something super important, just write in all caps and I'll try to catch it. All right. So this new Name of Field song, which I've actually already heard and reacted to on my Patreon, I haven't seen the music video yet because, as you might know, the actual song came out like a week or so before the music video. It just like popped up on YouTube, no announcement or anything, and it was just there. So I listened to it, really enjoyed it, had some cool sounds in it, but I haven't listened to it much since. So now I'm gonna watch the music video and it'll be a good time. All right. Oh, Mr. B, hello, welcome. EJBZ, Serious One. Thank you all for tuning in. I appreciate it. All right, let's jump into this. Name of Fila Style. Such a cool intro. Tribal hand drums. Okay, dang, there's so many different sounds in this song, like, and dynamics. It starts with those, yes, taiko drums. Who said that? Not hand drums, because they do use those big sticks things, which obviously is in the music video. I should have seen that. But starting with that, I don't think it shows up again for the rest of the song, does it? But then it just slams into these huge, heavy, slidey guitars. And then in the verse, it backs off again, has like those clean, almost James Bond soundtrack sounding guitars. And then the guitar work throughout the song, there's a little bit of it with those rhythmic, like, dim, 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 with the delay on them. But as the song goes on, the guitar work, it's unlike anything I've ever heard Name of Fila do before. It's very hybrid style. It obviously reminds me of like Polyphia, Tim Henson's guitar style a bit. But I think it's really cool. They're like pushing this new boundary that they've never really done before. Somehow they've taken their sound and evolved it and yet still have a lot of elements from that they've used in the past, but it's a lot different, I feel like, than anything else they put out. And again, that might have something to do with Haraguchi-san being the composer behind it. Because this one, and I can never remember the name of it, the one with like the Middle Eastern sound to it, Haraguchi-san composed both of those, right? So very cool experimental stuff. I'm going to back it up a bit. Hypnosis, yes. Thank you for the reminder. Okay, I'm going to go back to the verse because I want to hear when that second guitar comes in again. I'm guessing it's Saki because it's the right ear. Right here. Just so off the rhythm. And like right away when that chorus comes in, that big slide up the with the vibrato. Oh, reminds me of Matt Bellamy a bit. Yes. Okay, listen to the stuff that Maratatam's adding too. She's got between like the chorus parts, she'll throw in these little cymbal extras or whatever you want to call them. First it's a bell and then it's like a stacked cymbal going. Listen to this. Right here. Okay, not there. Here. There's a bell. And then here. It's just so fun. Dude, in the second verse, it's like completely different than the first verse. I absolutely love it when that happens. First of all, the drums are a lot more spaced out, a lot more rhythmic, you know? And then the guitars are like a completely different style, doing like an offbeat thing with the rhythm guitar, and then all the wacky little like experimental sounds. I just gotta hear it again. There's too much to take in. Okay. Yeah, they drop the first downbeat, first of all, to create this spacious rhythmic sound by using rests. Rests are the most underrated form of music because rests are what create rhythm, you know? Home Gnome, yes, please. Please be my memory. I need that. Yes, and then Mayu just straight up rapping in this second verse. It's like, I don't even know if I can call it a second verse. It's like a completely different part of the song. I'm just gonna go back to the first verse for a second to see how different it is. Backed it up a little too far, but I don't mind hearing it more. Okay, yeah. So like here, it's more of a straight up groove on the drums, and the bass is doing some really interesting stuff. But then on the second verse, go back to 115 where we left off, it's just completely different. I love that. Paul, I'm not recording yet, but that's because we're on YouTube still, and YouTube's not going to delete this live stream because it's just Nemophila, which is still safe. So this video will be available for replay once we're done. But I will record once we're on Twitch. All right, here we go. Those guitar sounds. Every member of the band did such a great job of giving that second verse a completely different feel. Even the way Maratatam was playing off of the weird guitar sounds, the whammy stuff, like that ch-ch-ch-ch. It's just completely keeping it fresh, man. Ugh. Okay. I'll shut up now. Cool video effects. what the heck? That part is so different. Hey, Simno, welcome. No, we're still on the first song. But, I mean, I guess so much has happened in this song that there was a lot to miss. But, I just got to hear this again. This guitar part, it's so different than anything I've heard from Name of Fila. Also, I gotta say, they did a great job with this video, too, because all the stuff in this video, relatively low-budget stuff, something I could do with the right footage, you know, but it's so tastefully done and well-executed, it looks super, you know, high-budget professional, you know? Right? Ah, I love it when the bass and guitar come together for the unison in that one part there. Like, it's all, like, the bass is keeping kind of a rhythm at first, but then it all comes together right here. Ah. Another riff that hasn't been in the song yet. Oh, man. Is that Mayu screaming? Because it sounds like so, like, thick and deep compared to what I usually hear her screaming. It's so full. Dang. That was intense. All right. Oh. What's that doc logo? Rock is not dead stuff well received today? That's good to hear. Oh. Greg says this video has lots of callbacks to many 90s videos. That's really interesting. Steve, yes, we're moving to Twitch. I'm just doing this Name of Fila reaction here to get the streams kicked off, make sure people know that we're about to go stream on Twitch. So, yes, we are now moving over to Twitch. We are going to be taking reaction requests now, or I guess I am, because Rosie's not here. So, sorry about that. I am just as bummed as you are. But... yeah, we'll be taking reaction requests over on Twitch and just hanging out, having some fun. And the link is in the description, but I will make sure it goes in the chat now, too. But anyway, thank you all so much for tuning in, hanging out for this Name of Fila reaction. Here's my Twitch link if you want to come hang out. It's free. You don't need an account to watch. So, yeah. I know it's kind of annoying, inconvenient to move from YouTube to Twitch, but that's the way it has to work for what we're doing here. So, I'll see you guys over there. It'll be like 2 minutes because I have to sign out of my Streamlabs and sign back in, but...